Today class we are take up back cross and reciprocal crosses. Second type of cross. The first cross is test cross. Second cross back cross. In back cross, what will happen? F1 plants which is crossed with homozygous dominant plant, and we will get dominant type of organisms, which is very helpful to improve the breeding. So back cross means the cross between F1 plants with homozygous dominant and parent, that is back cross. And this type of cross which is helps in this crop cross helps in improve the breeding in organisms. So F1 plants means in our mono hybrid cross, capital T and small t, and as well as small t and small t, these are the F1 plants actually. So these are the F1 plants in normal situations. These type of plants we have to crossed with the homozygous dominant plant. Crossed with the homozygous dominant plant. So first situation, capital T, small t, with the capital T, capital T. This is our wanted type of, this is our wanted type of breed. At least how many tall plants will get from next generation? So this parent capital T, small t, this parent capital T and capital T. Capital T, capital T, this is indicates with tall. Capital T, small t, that is indicates with tall. Capital T, capital T, that is also tall. Capital T, small t, here also tall. At least one dominant trait will we have to, which are, is there or not? Out of four plants, each plant contain at least one dominant trait, one dominant character. So here all plants shows tall. Our desirable situation or desirable character is we want to take tall. So any cross, any type of crossing, we will get tall. It means tall is our desirable organism character. So here tall plants we will get more by this process of back cross. So we will improve these type of breeding. Tall plants breeding will be improved. That is, what is that? Back cross. So in second situation, small t with capital T, capital T. What will happen? One of the parent small t, one of the parent capital T, capital T. So capital T then small t, capital T then small t, capital T then small t, capital T then small t. Here also same, all plants shows tall character. Here also second type of F1 plant we are crossed with the homozygous dominant plant, we will get all plants will tall. So here we are improved the breeding of tall plant. This back cross, which is very helpful to improve the breeding of back cross. Improve the breeding of back cross. In first situation also we will get tall plants. At least one dominant allele we have to observe, either present or not. In this case, at least one dominant character is present. Here also, at least one dominant character is present. This possibility done by back cross. Next to reciprocal cross. In case of dihybrid back cross also, how is it? It is possible. Capital R small r, capital Y small y is our F1 plant. This is F1 plant. This F1 plant we are crossed with homozygous dominant plant. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. This is our parent. So here four possibilities: capital R capital Y, then capital R small y, then small r capital Y, then small r small y. Here four possibilities: capital R capital Y, capital R capital Y, capital R capital Y, capital R capital Y. This is four gametes. So these are the gametes. These are the parents. These are the gametes. In dihybrid back cross also we are observed. This is the dihybrid F1 plant, heterozygous, round and yellow. Next, crossed with homozygous dominant trait, homozygous dominant plant. In this case, you have to observe, check Punnett's blackboard. One parent, capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, small r small y. F1 parent crossed with homozygous dominant trait, homozygous dominant plant. These are the gametes of both plants. Capital R capital R capital Y capital Y, capital R capital R capital Y small y, capital R small r capital Y capital Y, capital R small r capital Y small y. Then capital R capital R capital Y capital Y, capital R capital R capital capital Y small y, capital R small r capital Y capital Y, capital R small r capital Y small y. Next, capital R capital R capital Y capital Y, capital R capital R capital Y small y, capital R small r capital Y capital Y, capital R small r capital Y small y, capital R capital R capital Y capital Y, capital R capital R capital Y small y, capital R small r capital Y small y, capital Y capital Y. Next, capital R small r capital Y small y. In this dihybrid back cross also we will get at least one dominant. Here also dominant is there. Here red Y, R and Y capitals is there. Here also R and Y capitals is there. Here also R and Y capitals. Here also R and Y capitals. R and Y capitals. Here capitals. Here capitals. Here is there. Here is there. Here capitals is there. Here capitals is there. Here, 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 here. Complete 16 plants shows. 16 plants shows at least one dominant character. At least 16 plants shows all at least one dominant character. And one thing is, we are improved here, round and yellow plants. Here 16 plants we are improve the breeding of, improve the breeding of round and yellow plants, round and comma yellow plants. This is our back cross. We have to improve our desirable organism. So your desirable organism is round and yellow plant. So all 16 plants we will get round and yellow by the help of back cross.
back in the backrest F1 plants are crossed with two pure dominant characters, I mean pure homozygous dominant plant. And next cross, that is reciprocal cross. Third type of cross, reciprocal cross. In this cross, what will happen? Cross between two plants. Cross between two plants. These two plants use both male gametes as well as female gametes. So, these two plants use both male gametes and female gametes. Female gametes. In case of plant A and plant B, both plants were taken. What will happen? Plant A gives one time male gametes, one more time female gametes. In case this is act as a male plant, this is act as a female gives, I mean female gametes will give female gametes, sorry, male gametes, here also female gametes. It means plant A gives male gametes, plant B gives female gametes. Those gametes are capital A and capital A, here female gametes capital B as well as capital B. Cross between these two plants, so you are using Punnett square board. So this is male plant, this is female plant. Here male gametes are, that is A and A, female gametes are B and B. In next generation, capital A and capital B, then capital A and capital B, then capital A and capital B, then also capital A and capital B. This is one situation, means A plant gives male gametes, B plant gives female gametes. In second case, plant A gives female gametes, capital A. Plant B, that is female, male producing gametes, gives capital B and capital B. What will happen? See once, Punnett square board. Here both parents were taken, here male and here female gametes. Male gametes, here is there B and B. Female gametes, A and A. So BB means, that is a B plant gives male gametes, and small capital A, capital A gives by plant A. This is a female plant, act as a female plant. What will happen? Capital A, capital B. All plants shows same kind of genotype and phenotype. In this first situation also, this is situation one. This is situation two. In first situation and second situation, same type of genotype and same type of phenotype, but plants gives two different gametes. In plant A gives first time male gametes, second time female gamete, and plant B gives first time female gamete, second time male gamete, and any type of gamete they will give by the two plants, but the phenotype and genotypic ratios will be same. So two plants and they are act as a one time they produce male gametes and second time produce female gametes. So this is the reciprocal crosses. These plants are mainly reciprocal plants. This is reciprocal crosses. Here only difference is production of the male gametes and female gametes in different situation. So production of male and female gametes by the plants. Different is production of male gametes and female gametes by the plants is different. That is reciprocal crosses.